about a percent higher. Let's see if that does well. By the way, commodity stocks are seeing some more breakouts. Price volume breakout for a Hindalco, which is up 2% as well. Good going out there for this one. Bring up Tata Steel, bring up JSPL as well. I really want to see what that stock is doing, because on the CNX Midcap Index, JSPL has been a prime mover, the top gainer until now. Another 2.5% up in today's session as well. And really, that's the case for the chat with Ravi Uppal, that global metal stocks have rallied. There are some buy calls that have come in from global brokerages as well, Morgan Stanley in particular. But let's get in Mr. Uppal to speak about all that and more. He's MD and Group CEO of Jindal Steel & Power. To begin with, Mr. Uppal, of course, thanks for joining in. But the slowdown in the commodities basket doesn't seem to turn around. What is your outlook on base demand for steel and steel prices?
Well, you know, during the first 5 months of this year, that is from April to August, the steel demand in India has grown by 4%. But, you know, the imports have grown by 52%. The net result is that whatever increase in domestic demand took place, the benefit of it has gone to the importers. And the total net production in the first 5 months has gone up only by 1.3%. So I think, you know, any increase in demand in India will benefit the domestic manufacturers only when we build some kind of protection against reckless dumping which is being done in India. You know, some of the countries like China, Russia, Korea, they have built up huge capacity, but their own domestic demand has gone down considerably. So what they're trying to do is to dump their steel in the Indian market at prices which are simply not tenable for the Indian manufacturers. This is why a request was made to government to consider the facts of the case and also build adequate protection of domestic manufacturers against reckless dumping in the Indian market.
So, Mr. Uppal, you know, coming to the safeguard duty that was imposed by the government, is that sufficient to improve the domestic steel demand? And are you planning to improve prices of steel products?
Well, you know, it's just one product on which the safeguard duty has been sort of introduced, and that is HR coil. And the duty, you know, the whole case is under hearing right now. But in the meantime, considering the gravity of the situation, the government has put in an interim safeguard duty, which is about 20%. I think the case has been made for, you know, introducing safeguard duty to the tune of 25 to 30%. So, but I think this kind of safeguard duty comes, then it will, across all the products, then I think it will afford safety to the Indian manufacturers. You know, we also have to remember that the Indian manufacturers and the foreign manufacturers are not on a level playing field. You know, the Chinese manufacturers get incentive between 13 to 15% on what they produce in the name of so-called alloy steel from their government. You know, their freight costs, the logistic costs, the interest costs, the amount they pay for power, inland movement is substantially lower compared to the Indian manufacturers. The conversion cost of Indian manufacturers, you know, it can compete with anyone in the world. But when it comes to other services, support services like financing, logistics, etc., is simply beyond them. So all we are saying is that we must have a level playing field, and we should not allow people to use the Indian market as a dumping market.
Right. Your project, Mr. Uppal, and the expansion thereof in Odisha has recently been cleared as well. By when are you targeting to get the additional capacity on stream? And do you think demand in India can support the supply rush?
The Indian economy is set to grow between 7 to 7.5%, which is what government is working towards. I think the steel demand should grow at a rate of 8 to 10%. And I think that is something we really deserve, because right now our per capita consumption is among the world's lowest at a rate of about 60 kg per capita per year. And you know, we have a lot of headroom to grow. Our infrastructure has to grow, the railways are growing, industry is growing, so much housing has to grow. So I do foresee that the demand will certainly grow in the next 10 years time at the rate of about 8 to 10%.
Fair call. Sorry, Mr. Uppal, I just cut you there. But last couple of quick questions. Your debt stands at about 45,000 crores as of March 15. A lot of rating agencies have downgraded the debt last month because of the deteriorating financial ratios as well. How do you plan to manage these debt levels in the short term?
Well, you know, our company, you know, for us, the highest priority right now is to reduce our debt. We have taken all the necessary measures to make sure that we not only reduce debt, you know, contain any further growth, but to reduce the debt. But somehow, you know, at this point of time, when the steel and the power sector, both of them gone through a very testing time, you know, the amount of, you know, generation, internal earnings that we had were not to the extent that we had planned out. But it is all set to improve. Our, you know, for example, if you look at our production during the second quarter has once again, and also dispatches have gone up by 11%, you know, quarter on quarter compared to, you know, the capacity utilization of our power units has started to improve quite substantially. You know, so I think, you know, we are seeing some upward movement in both the sectors that we operate in. That basically means that, you know, as the busy season comes, our earnings should improve. And whatever earnings that we do, we will use it to reduce our debt. You've got to remember one thing, that a lot of this debt that we have has been caused by external factors. For example, you know, we were asked to pay 3,500 crores of additional, so, you know, duty on the coal that we mined since we started our operation. Nobody had planned out this kind of thing, but we taken the thing in its own stride. So, you know, so these are not a part of our debt for the operation. It was simply imposed on us and we had to service it. But now we are taking all the measures to see how we can cut down our debt. And, you know, we will also look at a selective divestment program of certain assets for which effort is underway. But I must say, you know, any sort of divestment that we do, it has to be done in the most optimal way. We will never rush into anything whereby we do not recover the real value of the assets. So therefore, we are taking very measured, very careful steps to see that we get the best value from anything that we divest. And at the same time, we are highly focused on ramping up our internal earnings.
And Ravi, finally coming to the power business, can we expect better PLF because of improved coal supply? Are the FSAs currently covering the total coal requirement as well?
First of all, I do agree with you that the availability of coal has improved thanks to the efforts done by the Ministry of Coal and the present government. The Coal India production has gone up nearly 10% in the first quarter, and government is putting a lot of thrust to ramp up this production still further. And with the enhanced availability of coal, obviously, we are able to run our plants to higher PLF. The second quarter PLF is substantially better than we had in the first quarter. And we do hope that the same level of coal availability will continue, and that should see higher and higher utilization, plant load availability, and the plant load factor, both of them should improve in Q3 and Q4. End of the day, we have 3,400 megawatts, you know, and we would definitely like to see that we fully utilize this capacity. As of this moment, we are on the right track.
Okay, Mr. Uppal, many thanks for taking time out and speaking with us and really putting things into perspective, given the global rally that's currently playing out in commodities and metals as well in particular. That's Jindal Steel. Remember, this was the only non-winner from yesterday's trade, and at a time when the likes of Hindalco, Vedanta, Tata Steel, they were all running up, this was the only laggard. But let's try and put sense on how the commodity markets have